Justice Kurian Joseph and Judge Honorable Supreme Court of India, Professor Jose Varghese, my learned friends and all my colleagues present here. It's indeed an honor for me to be present here amongst you all, and I think this is the second time that I'm coming to your college and addressing you all. But this time indeed it is special because I have the privilege of introducing one of my favorite judges of the Honorable Supreme Court. And why I say that he's one of my favorite judges from the Honorable Supreme Court is because, like we all know, for people like us who are not that senior in the profession and we are in the younger lot, the thing is that when we have to appear in Supreme Court, I was in fact telling the faculty members here one good quality, great quality I must say about Justice Kurian Joseph, that when people like us used to appear in Supreme Court, where you see all the legends, the mavericks in the Supreme Court, so people like us generally do not get that kind of indulgence from the court. But one of the incidents that I will point out here is when I was appearing in a matter, I was representing one of the parties, and in the same matter, we had some very, very great senior counsels like Mr. Mukul Rohatgi, Mr. Dushan Dave, and Mr. C.S. Vaidyanathan appearing in the same matter. So I was also appearing for one of the parties in that matter, and I did not know how to speak, because when such senior legends and your role models are arguing in court, you generally do not gather the courage to speak up or represent your client. But that's when Justice Kurian Joseph pointed out to me and called me to be in front, and he said, "Yes, gentlemen, what do you want to say?" So that's when I said, "Sir, I'm seeking some time to file a reply." So in spite of all the objections from the other side, sir was kind enough to give me a relief, in spite of me being very junior and quite young. Anyway, today we are not here to hear me, we are here to get enlightened from sir. So I'll just give a brief introduction about sir, because I'm sure that no words of any dictionary, all the adjectives that I can use, will not be able to give a proper introduction of sir. That would just run, I would run short of words, but I'll still make an attempt. So I would start by saying that sir is a perfect family man, a perfect judge, and above all, he's a perfect human being. Even these three expressions that I have used are not enough to throw the light on the personality of Hon'ble Justice Kurian Joseph. He was born in 1953. Hon'ble Mr. Justice Kurian Joseph joined the bar in 1979 before the Kerala High Court. He was designated in 1996 as a senior advocate, and after an illustrious career at the bar, he was elevated at the bench in 2000. He served as a judge at the Kerala High Court and twice as acting Chief Justice there before he was appointed as a Chief Justice of the Himachal Pradesh. On March 8, 2013, sir became a judge of the Honorable Supreme Court of India, and in his span of 18 years as a judge, Honorable Mr. Justice Kurian Joseph has more than a few landmark decisions that have shaped the jurisprudence of the country, including the Yaqub Memon case, the coal allocation scam case, and the triple talaq case. His calm and soothing demeanor, blanketed with a reassuring smile, is often spoken in high regards by the advocates and the litigants who appear in his court. He is best known for expeditious orders, especially in the matters where the oppressed and downtrodden classes are involved. With a solution-oriented approach to resolving disputes, and a sound knowledge of the law, and a patient audience to all arguing counsels in Honorable Supreme Court, Justice Kurian Joseph has been a beacon of legal excellence. He has often prompted fighting litigants to put an end to disputes. In fact, in his speech he gave during the farewell at Honorable Supreme Court, Honorable Mr. Justice Kurian Joseph had spoken on how unnecessary litigation was killing judicial time, the need for compassion to be shown by the courts and by the judges, and his passion for mediated settlement of disputes and arbitration awards. Today he has taken out time for all of us from his busy schedule, and I hope that I'm sure all of you are extremely excited like I am, so I'm just waiting to hear from sir. I'll not take more time. So we welcome you all, and sir, thank you for coming and taking out time. Over to you, sir.
Your friend Tariq is here. He's also a faculty in a prestigious law college. He doesn't lecture. He interacts with the students.
What advice would you give to young emerging practitioners, especially in arbitration?
Tariq. He is the most successful among the emerging practitioners in arbitration. He's just 7 years as a lawyer, but he's one of the very successful. It's a very specialized area. It's a very specialized.